together with Benjamin Mennel, we prepared a summary of the Plato activities since the last Chigos days. And for those of you who didn't hear about Plato yet, or maybe not remembering in details, what is the task of the Standing Committee Plato? So Plato stands for Performance Simulations and Architectural Trade-offs. The overall goal is to improve all components of the global geodetic reference frame. So that means terrestrial, celestial reference frame, and EUPs. To finally fulfill the Chigos requirement for accuracy and stability of the reference frame, which is 1 millimeter in position and 0.1 millimeter per year in velocity. And in order to reach these goals, basically four different kind of methods are applied within the Plato group. One method is doing simulations for an improved ground network geometry. The second one is do simulations for new observing concepts. Then the third method is to develop procedures and methods for an optimal usage of satellite collocations, already existing, but also simulations for future possible collocation satellites. And finally, develop methods for the optimal usage of all existing geodetic data, which goes beyond the standard procedures that are applied nowadays to derive the global geodetic reference frame products. So that means we have two kind of methods. So on the one hand, simulation studies and going along with developing improved analysis strategies. So I will show you a few examples that the different groups of the Plato members provided us as input. The first one is dedicated to the first method that I just mentioned, so simulations for improved ground network. That's one example by the colleagues from DGFI TU Munich, doing simulations for additional SLR sites to expand mainly the Australian SLR network. And so they appended to the existing real network, which are the black markers here, three potential additional SLR stations in the southern regions, southern hemisphere, Australia, and close to it. So they assumed specific performances for these stations, run several scenarios for simulations, and so as a result, they got that independent which site you add of these three red possible sites, it is beneficial for the origin of the terrestrial reference frame, mainly the sea translation. Adding all these three sites together yields the best improvement in the sea translation and also in the LOD parameter. And if you would ask for just one of these three possible sites, which is the best one, then McDonald Island here close to Antarctica is most beneficial for both TRF origin and EUPs. For the second method I mentioned at the beginning, the simulations for new observing concepts. We have several studies ongoing by different groups within Plato. One example is from the University of Hannover. They deal with lunar laser ranging, and they started simulations to do differential lunar laser ranging. So as a new method compared to the classical lunar laser ranging, where you have one station and one reflector. Here in the differential LLR, you have one station and then ranging to different types of reflectors on the moon. It is expected that you can enhance your knowledge on the lunar interior by this method, get better information for relativity tests and also for reference systems and transformations, because already the accuracy is greatly going down. And the major error source, which is the atmosphere, is significantly reduced. A second example for new observing concept is done in Vienna. So they are doing simulation of VLBI observations to Galileo satellites. And they focus on parameters like called dilution of precision and apply this method to the UT1 minus UTC parameters, so the major VLBI information, and use this kind of quality measure in the VLBI scheduling to get improved scheduling for parameter determination. And you have here one example, which is picked from a presentation given at EGU this year. And just the general information, the lower this U dot value is denoted to a satellite position, then the VLBI observations are able to derive a better UT1 minus UTC value. Third example for new observing concepts is done by the GFC groups. They have different projects. One just finished by the end of 2020, the Project Advantage. It was already reported several times during the duration of this project. Here you have a new kind of configuration of satellite segments. And one example of this project is shown here, that the geocenter coordinates get greatly improved compared to standard methods. And a new follow-on project called NextGNSS for GIGOS just started this year, and is dealing with simulation of new observation types and looking at their impact on all geodetic products like TRF, EUPs, and also gravity field. Another method is, or another question is, how to optimally use satellite collocations. And there also the GFC group has a project, GIGOS SIM, and the follow-on project, GIGOS SIM 2. So simulation of the global geodetic observing system for all four space geodetic techniques at one collocated satellite. And from there, combination studies of weekly SLR and VLBI datum-free normal equation systems via these space ties. They got nice results and an improvement for the terrestrial reference frame. And as a preliminary result, they see that the agreement is on the sub-millimeter level, so quite a good and interesting result. Finally, an example of a study related to the questions how to optimally use all existing data, so more data than just the standard daily processing is using. So here studies are done with the combined processing of GNSS and LEOs, low Earth orbiting satellites, like Swarm, GRACE, GRACE Follow-On and JASON. And the focus of this study are on the scale and the satellite phase center offsets of the GNSS satellites, and the determination of both is possible within a GNSS solution if the LEO satellites are included. And they could show within their studies that really the correlation between satellite PCOs and terrestrial scale decreases nicely when the LEO data is included. As a consequence, the PCOs are different compared to what is used now, also the terrestrial scale. And this goes also along with what Suha showed with the development of the GNSS scale. And here the group also did comparisons, what they derive with their method, including LEOs as a scale and PCOs with the values that you have from the Galileo side. Yeah, so in summary, despite the pandemic situation, there were a lot of activities, research studies within the Plato group since the last CIGOS days, with a broad variety of questions that were tried to answer. And these studies are still ongoing. There are many research projects that got funded and are also still ongoing. We had at the EGU this year, the virtual EGU, a session where Plato topics were included, similar to the previous years. We had a virtual Plato meeting on May this year, and just last week, I got an information distributed within the ILRS by Toshi, which could be a Plato activity, let's say. So the Russian colleagues plan to launch four interesting satellites, two kind of Blitz satellites called Blitz M2 and two type of single glass sphere satellites called GLASS. So very interesting satellites for SLR, which are thought to provide good data. So the idea was to do here simulations to quantify the improvements for geodetic parameters due to SLR data to such kind of satellites. Yeah, this came just last week, and I think we will discuss within the Plato group who is willing to do there something. That's from my side. Thank you for your attention.